The presidency on Saturday says there was no rift between President Muhammadu Buhari and the national leader of the All Progressive Congress, APC, Bola Tinubu. According to a statement signed by presidential spokesman Garba Shehu, the two are in touch with one another and their relationship remains as strong as ever. The presidency's comment comes after President Buhari dissolved the party's National Working Committee amid a party crisis in Edo State, which led to the exit of Governor Godwin Obaseki. Joining us now is the senior special assistant to the president and media and publicity, Garba Shehu. Thank you very much for joining us on the news.
Thank you for this opportunity.
Can you tell us what necessitated the rebuttal, or should I say call it clarification, on the relationship between the president and the national leader of the APC?
Well, as we said in that statement, there are people who are pretending that they know what is going on. They actually, they don't. We have read many analyses online, offline, people talking about winners and losers following the dissolution of the NEC, and trying to drive a wedge between these very strong partners, President Muhammadu Buhari and Ashuaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu. So what we are saying in effect is that, look, before you project yourself as an analyst pretending to know something, you better know your facts. There is nothing of a rift between the two of them. They're in touch, as we said, with one another. And these efforts have been ongoing in any way to split that relationship. They have failed, using all of the intellectuals in the opposition and their friends in the media. They failed before, and they will not be succeeding this time around.
This will not be the first time we're getting this kind of clarification, so to speak. But people are skeptical, as you will agree, when it comes to statements saying that all is well, when sometimes it turns out that it is not well. We have a clear case of Adams Oshomole and Governor Obaseki. At some point, they came up and said it was the media that was misrepresenting the facts.
Well, you can cite many instances like that, but there are no cases, two cases that are exactly the same. Between President Muhammadu Buhari and Ashuaju Bola Ahmed Tinubu, they have a relationship and they have cultivated a way and their means of sustaining that relationship. Only the two of them, between themselves, they know how they manage this relationship. Any interlopers trying to say this is how it is going will be mistaken, because they won't get their facts right.
All right. Can you help us clarify the argument? There are people who are saying that the president ambushed the neck by, you know, that speech dissolving the NWC.
No, there was no ambush there, because there was wide-ranging consultation. And as you may have reported yourselves, you have seen the comings and the goings into the villa by party leaders, by governors, and all of that. It clearly was suggestive of a high level of consultation going on, and the fact that the president consulted widely. This was why the suggestions that he put before the meeting that were adopted as resolutions were carried with unanimity. Because before the meeting took place, there was wide-ranging consensus behind the curtains. And the agreement was resolved. Therefore, it was a smooth sail for him, because all opinions had been carried along.
All right. Just before we talk about something else, there is, you say he was advised, he consulted widely, but there was a court order being moved around by Mr. Etter's group earlier, saying that the person who convened that neck meeting was no longer a member of the party. Does it mean that that court's judgment has become invalid?
Well, unfortunately, I'm just a journalist like yourself. I'm not a lawyer myself. But what I know is that even 24 hours before that meeting, there was a court order coming from Jos Plateau State asking Giadom, go ahead, convene a meeting and preside over. So if there are conflicting orders from the courts of the land, it's not for me. It is for the courts themselves to sort themselves out. But clearly, the president was persuaded that he stood on a very solid legal ground. That, as we said, that the law substantially was on the side of Giadon. And because the president is a law-abiding person, he presented himself for the meeting in the belief that it was in accordance with the law of the land.
All right. What are your expectations now, especially after the statement by Bola Tinubu and the one that you signed on behalf of the presidency, that all warring parties will come together and accept this decision, that this committee that's been set up will come up with the convention and other issues in 6 months' time?
Well, the statement by Ashwaju Bola Tinubu is much welcome and is a confirmation of the position of the presidency that there is nothing amiss between the two leaders of the APC. And the people who are suggesting that Ashwaju Bola Tinubu has been put at a disadvantage by this are clearly wrong. And Ashwaju has himself said he's clearly in support of this action. Now, as to what will follow, we are optimistic that, look, given the assemblage of men and women on that team, the interim leadership of the party, they are the best that the party can produce. So therefore, we have a team that is trusted, that is competent, that is capable of carrying out the directive of the NEC, which is to organize a convention, run the party in the interim, and organize a convention leading to the election of new leaders within 6 months. This will be done, and I assure you that there will be no disappointments.
Just for the records, is the president now showing interest in who succeeds him with this intervention, or he is still indifferent, so to say?
I will not say yes or no to your question. All I will say is that the president has a massive mandate from Nigerians to govern the country for 4 more years. And he has clearly spelled out his priorities: economy, security, and fighting corruption. These are the things that are before him. The party problem was a distraction. Now that he has really tackled it head on, let's forge ahead and deliver on promises. When the time comes, certainly there will be a discussion on what becomes of 2023, and the president's position will be known.
All right, thank you very much, Mr. Garba Shehu, for your thoughts on the news.
Thank you, I appreciate it.